Hey guys, this is Junna and I'm back. So this is another video about scleroderma awareness. So gusto ko lang i-update kayo regarding my sickness and how it's been so far. I was diagnosed in February, officially diagnosed in February. I have started taking my medications ng February. So right now it's April, so it's been a couple of months, and then there's some progress. Honestly, malaki na yung progress, although for real, it's not gonna go back in the way it is. So if you're familiar with, which is you are not, I think everyone is familiar na, you know, once a scarring happened, the scar is there, so it's irreversible, and it could get better. It might look better or, you know, lighten how it looks, but the scar is already there and it's never gonna go away. So basically, ganun din sa skin ko and most likely sa internal organs na maapektuhan. So I think we're at the point where we just want to feel better more than, you know, wanting those physical changes to be reversed. Kasi there's no really point on dwelling with that, and I don't want to have that burden and headache, because first, financially, it's very expensive. Second, there's a lot of emotions I would need to invest there, wherein right now, if I do that, I won't be very wise. Emotion and energy, of course. When you emote, you exert energy out of it. So I don't want to dwell on that. So we done. So so far I'm gonna show you the pictures of, you know, some symptoms that I have. So the first photo was taken in January. This is when all my symptoms are like hype, like I'm on the hype of all the symptoms that I got. And then the other photo was taken in March, which is after a month of taking the supplements and some meds. So hindi po yan ilaw lang, so that's really the spot where I wanted it taken, kasi yung itong sa likod ko, hindi ko siya na lulusyonan, hindi ko siya na lalagyan ng oil, so hindi ko siya natatouch. So basically I was, you know, in my head, I even told this to the doctor, in my head, if nag-improve siya, I was hoping I'm also improving in from within. Yun. So, hopefully, it is. Although, sabi nung pinakita ko yun sa doctor, sabi niya, it's actually a good sign. So, I'm only taking 4 medications, 4 or 5 medications right now. So, most of dun are supplements pa lang. So, wala pa akong immunosuppressant drugs. The reason why I don't have immunosuppressant drugs is because meron akong latent TB, meaning natutulog na TB. So there are like 2 types of, you know, like TB, isang active, isang latent, which is yung tulog. So mga klase ng TB na ganito, it could forever be sleeping or it could be triggered kapag bumaba yung immune system mo. So sa case ko, dahil iinom ako ng immunosuppressant, I have to assume na mag-activate siya. The pulmonologist decided that I have to take INH plus vitamin B complex. I think pag may active TB ka, talagang umiinom ka nun for 9 months. So, inom din ako ng INH plus vitamin B for 9 months. Pero, for me particularly, before ko mainom yung immunosuppressant, I have to take these drugs, the INH plus vitamin B, for about 2 to 3 months before ako ma-clear at makapag-start ng immunosuppressant. So parang ang mangyari, itatanim muna nila yung INH sa katawan ko to ensure na hindi siya mag-activate. Because the doctor think I do have scleroderma since 2 to 3 years ago. Tapos nag-trigger siya, yung mga symptoms lumala siya because probably of stress and yun nga, the environment that where I'm at. So guys, if ever na may pinagdadaanan din kayo ng ganitong sakit, it's important na you take notes. Para I didn't do this prior, like nung nagsisimula, no, I have my papers, my lab test, and umaasa ako na, alam mo yun, bigay lang ako ng bigay, basahin nyo, tapos sabihin nyo sa akin, kumbaga, hindi ako sobrang involved. Until nito lately, I realized that I have to take down notes, talk about everything that I'm feeling related dun sa sakit ko. Kasi if not, hindi talaga din nila ma-identify. Kasi nga, sobrang daming factors. And if you will not be able to tell the story, which they rely to so much, bukod dun sa test, hindi nila maintindihan kung ano yung next course of action. Yun, take down notes, sa, lalo na yung mga gamot na iniinom nyo, ano yung naramdaman nyo after uminom nyo yung gamot na yun, ano yung napapansin yung bagong sintomas, yung mga sintomas na nararamdaman nyo, lumalala ba, na bumabalik ba yung pakiramdam, or nawala ba siya nung ininom. So, you really have to observe your body. Ayun. So, especially yung sakit na ganito, yung autoimmune diseases, meron silang tinatawag na flare-up. Which is before, hindi ko naiintindihan. Pero now, naiintindihan ko. So, yung flare-up, yung mga moment na, yung mga sintomas mo na nangyayari. Kasi with this, there are days na okay kayo. And then, there are days na you're not. There are days, meron this one time, gumising ako ng umaga and I'm feeling so well. Sobrang okay ako. Parang wala akong sakit. And I was, you know, like, I was really happy the whole day. And then after a couple of days, just kung nagising ako, and everything hurts. And I just feel that I don't wanna get out of bed. And then, like, recently, I had my menstruation. And on the second day of my menstruation, I remember feeling really sad at around 3 in the morning. I just cried. And then at that time, gising pa si Dexter, and I was like, babe, I'm feeling sad. And I don't know why. And then I wanna cry. And I wanna cry in sadness, which I don't understand. Alam mo yun. And then, ayun, I asked, and then, like, it's almost 5, and so it was like past 5, so we waited for like a couple of hours. Sabi namin, lakad kami to be cheesy. So we walked, we went to Purdue Circle, you know, just walk, breathe some, you know, some air. I wouldn't say fresh, pero breathe some air. And, upupo lang kami sa bench, and then we talk. And then we grab my favorite coffee, and then ininom kami, balik kami dun sa bench, umupulog kami, just, you know, talk again for a little bit. So probably we were out for like an hour, and then, you know, went back home. And then okay na ulit. So I was like, it's just super weird kasi I don't really feel those, siguro unless nung mga days na pregnant ako, but what I usually do nung mga time na yun, you know, I just go out and grab coffee, ako lang. You know, I don't wanna be with anyone. But at this time, you know, I ask Dexter. Honestly, I was wondering, kasi when I read some of the stories of patients abroad, usually meron sila mga antidepressant automatic, no, added on their list. I'm glad when I'm not at that point. I'm really scared of medications, and kasi I'm ignorant. Ignorant to the point na hindi talaga ako mahilig uminom ng gamot. So natatakot talaga ako. But then so far, you know, lahat ng meds na tinitake ko are, I would say, necessity in my condition, and it's really making me feel better. So you really have to trust the doctor at this point. Your faith and your brain is powerful, you know. But I mean, you also have to trust the science. And don't get me wrong, you know, I changed my diet. So we added green juice sa diet ko. So umiiwas ako sa mga preservatives. You know, the usual healthy stuff that we're supposed to be doing naman even before na may sakit tayo. So I'm trying to cut down yung pork. I can't talaga yung meat totally kasi ewan ko. So I think I just really have to do that as well. So yun. So basically that's the update. Pray for me. Pray for me guys. I do hope na hindi. So probably ulitin yung mga CT scan ko na yan. Diyos ko. Buti na lang may health card talaga. So yun. So if you are in the same situation that I am, if you're still if you are in the process of being diagnosed, what I would advise you to do is huwag niyo na akong gayahin na natatakot ng mga time na yun to know. The more you know, the more you'd understand. Umiwas kayo sa mga Google image, pero read. Pero huwag din i-exaggerate yung pagbabasa. It's good that you are at least familiar. The doctor would say na wala, huwag niyo masyadong intindi ganun kasalala or what. It's good to know kung ano yung, alam mo yun, ano yung possibilities. But of course, do not dwell on it. Honestly, sa Google na nang hinahanap ko is success story. Yung mga taong gumaling, yung mga taong nabuhay until 60, yung mga taong nagkaroon ng chance, alam mo yun, na mabuhay ng normal. So, that's because that's what I'm aiming for. Andito na to eh. Hindi ko na siya maalis sa sistema ko. So, why do I need to dwell dun sa mga hindi ko na makokontrol? So, honestly, for me as a person, ako lang to personally, I wanted to look for success stories talaga, which there's not much out there. Lahat ng malala, yun yung pinapakita nila. Which is good kasi it makes you aware. Pero, I think there should be a balance, diba? Hindi, kasi parang hopeless, alam mo yun, hopeless case. But I understand as well why they're doing that, you know. The more people are aware how severe it could be, the more awareness it gives and more attention people could give to it. But for someone who's sick and already with the condition, what you wanna know, what you wanna read is actually something positive naman, something to give you hope. Yes, I have this disease, so how can I live with it? Diba? So that's just me. Yun. So I hope this adds to that collection, yung not really a success story yet, wala pa. Masyado pang maaga. Pero, yung hope, sana, if you may sakit kayo ngayon, you're also looking for answers to your question. And kung it's na to sa mga tanong nyo, then the answer is, if you want, you can actually live a normal life. And God will always find a way. So, that's it. Thank you guys for watching, and have a great day. Bye!